Behukotai, Leviticus 26, 3, 27, 34. If you follow my laws and faithfully observe my commandments, I will grant your rains in their season, so that the earth shall yield its produce and the trees of the field their fruit. Your threshing shall overtake the vintage, and your vintage shall overtake the sowing. You shall eat your fill of bread and dwell securely in your land.
Second, I will grant peace in the land, and you shall lie down untroubled by anyone. I will give the land respite from vicious beasts, and no sword shall cross your land. Your army shall give chase to your enemies, and they shall fall before you by the sword. 5 of you shall give chase to 100, and 100 of you shall give chase to 10,000. Your enemies shall fall before you by the sword. I will look with favor upon you and make you fertile and multiply you, and I will maintain my covenant with you.
Third Aliyah. You shall eat old grain long stored, and you shall have to clear out the old to make room for the new. I will establish my abode in your midst, and I will not spurn you. I will be ever present in your midst. I will be your God, and you shall be my people. I, Adonai, am your God who brought you out from the land of Egyptians to be their slaves no more, who broke the bars of your yoke and made you walk erect. But if you do not obey me and do not observe all these commandments, if you reject my laws and spurn my rules so that you do not observe all my commandments and you break my covenant, I in turn will do this to you. I will wreak misery upon you, consumption and fever, which cause the eyes to pine and the body to languish. You shall sow your seed to no purpose, for your enemies shall eat it. I will set my face against you. You shall be routed by your enemies, and your foes shall dominate you. You shall flee, though none pursues. And if, for all that, you do not obey me, I will go on to discipline you sevenfold for your sins, and I will break your proud glory. I will make your skies like iron and your earth like copper, so that your strength shall be spent to no purpose. Your land shall not yield its produce, nor shall the tree of the land yield their fruit. And if you remain hostile toward me and refuse to obey me, I will go on smiting you sevenfold for your sins. I will loose wild beasts against you, and they shall bereave you of your children and wipe out your cattle. They shall decimate you, and your roads shall be deserted. And if these things fail to discipline you for me, and you remain hostile to me, I too will remain hostile to you. I, in turn, will smite you sevenfold for your sins. I will bring a sword against you to wreak vengeance for the covenant. And if you withdraw into your cities, I will send pestilence among you, and you shall be delivered into enemy hands. When I break your staff of bread, 10 women shall bake your bread in a single oven. They shall dole out your bread by weight, and though you eat, you will and shall not be satisfied. But if, despite this, you disobey me and remain hostile to me, I will act against you in wrathful hostility. I, for my part, will discipline you sevenfold for your sins. You shall eat the flesh of your sons and the flesh of your daughters. I will destroy your cult places and cut down your incense stands, and I will heap your carcasses upon your lifeless fetishes. I will spurn you. I will lay your cities in ruin and make your sanctuaries desolate, and I will not savor your pleasing odors. I will make the land desolate so that your enemies who settle in it shall be appalled by it. And you I will scatter among the nations, and I will unsheath the sword against you. Your land shall become a desolation, and your cities a ruin. Then shall the land make up for its Sabbath years throughout the time that it is desolate, and you are in the land of your enemies. Then shall the land rest and make up for its Sabbath years. Throughout the time that it is desolate, it shall observe the rest that it did not observe in your Sabbath years while you were dwelling upon it. As for those of you who survive, I will cast a faintness into their hearts in the land of their enemies. The sound of a driven leaf shall put them to flight. Fleeing as though from the sword, they shall fall through none pursues. Though none pursues. With no one pursuing, they shall stumble over one another as before the sword. You shall not be able to stand your ground before your enemies, but shall perish among the nations, and the land of your enemies shall consume you. Those of you who shall survive shall be heartsick over their iniquity in the land of your enemies. More, they shall be heartsick over the iniquities of their forebears, and they shall confess their iniquity and the iniquity of their forebears, in that they trespassed against me, yea, were hostile to me. When I, in turn, have been hostile to them and have removed them into the lands of their enemies, then at last shall their obdurate heart humble itself, and they shall atone for their iniquity. Then will I remember my covenant with Jacob. I will remember also my covenant with Isaac, and also my covenant with Abraham, and I will remember the land. For the land shall be forsaken of them, making up for its Sabbath years by being desolate of them, while they atone for their iniquity, for the abundant reason that they rejected my rules and spurned my laws. Yet, even then, when they are in the land of their enemies, I will not reject them or spurn them so as to destroy them, annulling my covenant with them. For I, Adonai, am their God. I will remember in their favor the covenant of with the ancients, whom I freed from the land of Egypt in the sight of the nations to be their God. I, Adonai. These are the laws, rules, and instructions that God established through Moses on Mount Sinai with the Israelite people.
Fourth, Hashem spoke to Moses, saying, speak to the Israelite people and say to them, when any party explicitly bows to Hashem, the equivalent for a human being, the following scale shall apply. If it is a male from 20 to 26 years of age, the equivalent is 50 shekels of silver by the sanctuary weight. If it is a female, the equivalent is 30 shekels. If the age is from 5 years to 20 years, the equivalent is 20 shekels for a male and 10 shekels for a female. If the age is from 1 month to 5 years, the equivalent for a male is 5 shekels of silver, and the equivalent for a female is 3 shekels of silver. If the age is 60 years or over, the equivalent is 15 shekels in the case of a male and 10 shekels for a female. But if one cannot afford the equivalent, that person shall be presented before the priest, and the priest shall make an assessment. The priest shall make the assessment according to what the vower can afford. If the vow concerns any animal that may be brought as an offering to Hashem, any such that may be given to Hashem shall be holy. One may not exchange or substitute another for it, either good for bad or bad for good. If one does substitute one animal for another, the thing vowed and its substitute shall both be holy. If the vow concerns any impure animal that may not be brought as an offering to Hashem, the animal shall be presented before the priest, and the priest shall assess it. Whether high or low, whatever assessment is set by the priest shall stand. And if one wishes to redeem it, one-fifth must be added to its assessment. If any party consecrates a house to Hashem, the priest shall assess it. Whether high or low, as the priest assesses it, so it shall stand. And if the one who has consecrated the house wishes to redeem it, one-fifth must be added to the sum at which it was assessed, and then it shall be returned.
Fifth Aliyah. If any party consecrate to Hashem any land holding, Its assessment shall be in accordance with its seed requirement, 50 shekel of silver to a homer of barley seed. If the land is consecrated as of the Jubilee year, its assessment stands. But if the land is consecrated after the Jubilee, the priest shall compute the price according to the years that are left until the Jubilee year, and its assessment shall be so reduced. And if the one who consecrated the land wishes to redeem it, one-fifth must be added to the sum at which it was assessed, and it shall be passed back. But if the one who consecrated it does not redeem the land, and the land is sold to another party, it shall no longer be redeemable. When it is released in the Jubilee, the land shall be holy to Hashem as land prescribed. It becomes a priest's holding.
Sixth Aliyah. If one consecrates to Adonai land that was purchased, which is not one's landholding, the priest shall compute the proportionate assessment up to the Jubilee year, and the assessment shall be paid as of that day, a sacred donation to Adonai. In the Jubilee year, the land shall revert to the one from whom it was bought, whose holding the land is. All assessments shall be by sanctuary weight, the shekel being 20 geraz. A firstling of animals, however, which, as a firstling, is Adonai's, cannot be consecrated by anybody. Whether ox or sheep, it is Adonai's. But if it is of impure animals, it may be ransomed at its assessment, with one-fifth added. If it is not redeemed, it shall be sold at its assessment. But of all that anyone owns, be it human or beast or landholding, nothing that has been prescribed for Adonai may be sold or redeemed. Every prescribed thing is totally consecrated to Adonai.
Seventh Aliyah. No human being who has been prescribed can be ransomed. That person shall be put to death. All tithes from the land, whether seed from the ground or fruit from the tree, are God's. They are holy to God. If any party wishes to redeem any tithes, one-fifth must be added to them. All tithes of the herd or flock, of all that passes under the shepherd's staff, every tenth one shall be holy to God. One must not look out for good as against bad, or make substitution for it. If one does make substitution for it, then it and its substitute shall both be holy. It cannot be redeemed. These are the commandments that God gave Moses for the Israelite people on Mount Sinai.